in the Krutayuga. In the Krutayuga, the man gets the ultimate knowledge. It means he will not use a rocket, but still he can go across the globe. He will not open the eyes, but still he can see the vision anywhere by closing it, even in the other planets also. This will be the tremendous capacity of the man. As such, the man has come. The highest energy to the lowest energy is one aspect. So the man moves from higher energy to lower energy, higher senses to lower senses. The higher senses will be in the Krutayuga. The earth is formed in the Krutayuga, not in the Kaliyuga. The man is present in the Kaliyuga. Whatever he has lost inside, he is trying to produce it outside. This we call it as a technological knowledge. That is technologically getting the knowledge. Whatever we have lost inside, get in an outside material. But every material is inside. Since we are unable to use it, we are finding an alternative for an internal thing. As said, the man is not knowledgeable today. The man in the previous time was more knowledgeable. Consequently, people could not understand. They said that the man is evolved out of a monkey. No, the man is moving to become a monkey. And in the sense, it means he is losing knowledge day by day. But the man will never become monkey, nor the monkey will never become a man. The monkey is a different species. The man is a different species. So the man moves from the highest knowledge to the lowest knowledge. And the man is evolved when the highest knowledge, when all the indriya, the jnanendriya, the karmendriya, the mind, the intellect, everything was strong. He was able to transcend himself to that particular state. Consequently, the man is evolved from the higher energy to the lower energy, not from lower energy to the higher energy. As said, the man was very strong as the Paramatma. That was his capacity. So, the way the evolution evolved, that is called as Chaturyuga. In this swarm of to and fro motion, there are 1000 Chaturyuga, totaling to 432 crores of years. So, the total life is 1000 oscillations of the earth, moving away and moving toward the sun. And this is the totality of life of the earth atmosphere. So in this manner, the various time patterns has also been found. And if what is the time deciding factor? The time is basically comes on what? The time comes on basically because all the changes are done by the light. When a particle is bombarded by the light, what happens is the light which bombard the particle brings a change of state. So all changes in the universe has been done by the sun, the changes in the earth atmosphere is done by the moon, the changes is done by the particle of matter of the light which is traveling at a velocity of 3 lakhs kilometers per second. The human body is a special feature in which it can travel both in arohana and avarohana. That is an ascending energy and descending energy. Whereas the universe works only in the descending energy, from the Paramatma to the particle of matter in the earth. Whereas in a human, at the time of creation, he works from the Paramatma to the particle of the body. And also he can move from the particle of the physical matter of the body back to the Paramatma. It means he can work both ascending as well as descending. Up to the level of the soul, his velocity will be the Indriya Vega, that is 3 lakhs kilometers per second. Once he transcends beyond the soul, that is in the chakras, called as Manipura, then Anahata, Vishuddhi, Agna, he will be traveling beyond velocity of flight. Once he gets into this state, using the Gayatri Mantra, or the prana of the human body, which is called the Gayatri Mantra, he can transcend himself and reach beyond velocity of flight. So Vedic knowledge has been obtained by the people by going beyond velocity of light. It means the knowledge to obtain need not do any experiments for that matter. One can visualize that knowledge within the human body. So in this forum, all forms of knowledge was known to the human. They wanted to study about the material. They studied inside, not by dissection, but by traveling inwards with the ray of light. Ra is ray of light. So in the Ayush, that is when we are living, they traveled with the ray of light faster than that. That is what is called as Ayurveda. So Ayurveda also has come, that is the material science has come on account of an internal movement by crossing the Agni Adi body. The changes done by the Agni Adi body is what is called as Rigveda. So the Rigveda was visualized when the matter was pure. Bringing the matter pure is the purpose of the Ayurveda. As said, the Ayurveda became a Upaveda of the Rigveda. That is the one which takes to the knowledge of the Rigveda. The Ayurveda was also visualized when the mind and the Agni of the body transcended beyond the physical body, traveled through every particle of the body, and traveling this is what is called as, in this what happened, the breath and the nervous system travels beyond that. That is called as, goes beyond that. So you will know all the effect of the air. This is what is called as Dhanurveda. Dhanurveda means not archery. Dhanurveda means the breath of the body and the nervous system joining together and moving toward the Paramatma is called as Dhanurveda. As such, the Ayurveda has an Upaveda called as Dhanurveda. The various waves of length of various wavelengths of energy accumulates in the body, and these wavelengths has come on account of moving toward the soul and the mind. As such, the wave is what is been generated from the earthly matter. The earthly matter is called as Ga. The wave travels through the breath of the body called as Ga, Da, and reaches the soul with the help of the particles of the matter. That is why this is called as Gandharva Veda. Gandharva Veda means moving with the physical matter and the breath in the form of the various wavelengths of energy, and that has led to the knowledge of the various wavelengths of energy that is there in the human body, which is called as Samaveda. So the three Vedas are visualized by making an internal function of the body. This is called as Gandharva Veda for Samaveda, Upaveda of Rigveda is Ayurveda, then we have got the Dhanurveda for Ayurveda, the purification of the matter within that is by lifting up the mind, the body being lifted up, the mind gave what is called as Vaishya Veda, which is the root of the Atharva Veda. So Vedas were visualized when the man transcendent beyond the velocity of light, for which what he has to do is, he must not travel outside, on the contrary, he must travel inside. This process is called as Pratyahara or Digbandhana Vyavastha. So in Digbandhana, he transcended in this manner, and the way the solar system evolved, the human body also evolved in the same manner. There is no difference between this and that. And also there are different intervals of time. As we have studied, the air will last for so many years, the earth will last for so many years. Similarly, in the earthly body also lasts for a limited number of years. The life of the human body is 432 crores of years or 120 years when the heartbeat goes exactly at around 67 beats a minute. So at 67 beats a minute, the man will last for so many 120 years. It means the rise of energy takes place for the 60 years and the fall of energy for the human body takes for 60 years. That is how the device comes. So the rise of the energy is 60 years. That is why our calendar has a 60 year calendar called as Prabhava, Vibhava and so on. What happens in the first 60 years of the life of the human, correspondingly we will reduce it. This is what is called as 120 years. This is called as Daiva Varsha. That is how the Prakriti has got a rise and fall. So the Prakriti in the human body, which is Alpa Prana, has got a rise of 60 years of life and a fall of 60 years of life. So the 60 years of life and 60 years fall of life has got tremendous influence on what is called as the Earth's Prana, that is bringing the rain, air and other things into the consideration. Each particular year will have a particular system of operation. It will repeat after every 120 years of the life on the earth. As such, we had done a calendar for 60 years, right from Prabhava, Vibhava and so on. So it means the Vedic system is purely a scientific system in which the evolvement has come on account of getting into the nature and becoming that. Whatever the nature you want to know, you become that. Your mind and indriyas must become that. Consequently, you got the knowledge. So it means the full knowledge was obtained through Advaita, thinking that everything within the human body is there, whatever that is there in the solar system is there within the human body.